What's going on, guys? It's Ark here, and welcome back to episode 22 of No Man's Sky. Now, last episode, we really kind of just screwed around. I didn't really want to do too much more into Null the First Traveler. So we did some drop pod things. Near one of these drop pods, we found a bunch of cargo containers here. I mean, just look at this. This is wonderful. It's awesome. And around them were these wonderful condensed carbon crystals. And then, of course, knowledge stone. See? There's the drop pod. We grabbed it. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my base, as I promised you guys, and do this two more times. Oh, wait, did we save? Yes, we did. But you know what? Let's save again, just in case. Now, the thing is, I don't really have I only have like maybe one or two. Or like, I think one, technically. One of my drop pod coordinates left. But I promised you guys I'd show you that the exocraft can do it. This game is updated to the latest so you should be able to do this even on the latest update to date, which is 9/24/22. That sneeze, that was hurt. All the different detection and subroutines are online. There's the drop pod coordinates. And so now we fly over there like we have for the last two. Take long to cross a planet. Give her a monotoxin. There's enough gamma weed around here. Jeez. this stuff was smokable, I'd probably be higher than a kite all the time. Good lord. But it's not. That's the secret. Entire time. One, two, and three. And then, of course, save and charge. It just gives us more nanites in the game. Then we get navigation data, which we can use to find more drop pods. I think that's one I've already been to, but we'll check it out. Just in case. It's not wanting to pulse gauge. It's not wanting to pulse gauge right, or pulse jump correctly. To regular fly there, so it's gonna take a little bit. There we go. Probably what I've already been to. If not, this might be one that I found before, but I wasn't able, but I didn't have the stuff to fix it at the time. No, it looks like I've already done this one. We'll know when we get to the antenna. Yep, this is the Lizab encampment. This was the first one we did last episode. Base. Gibramona Tatsu. Bullcrap, looking in the area is not clear. Okay, so I have no more drop pod coordinates. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hop in the roamer, hit down, go to my Exocraft signal booster, and scan for drop pods. Drop pod already detected instantly. Honestly, the drop pod coordinates become kind of obsolete at this point, so... But these drop pods tend to be a lot closer than the ones in the coordinates that I have, than the coordinates that you can receive, so... See, before the other ones were like hours away, this one's only like a couple minutes, like not even a minute away practically. Of course, we get to see this beautiful planet. This beautiful yellow planet. You see, there's on our way over, we found this. I haven't even been here before. And usually, these, Damaged machineries have salvaged data nearby. For some reason, this time it doesn't. Or I might be looking in the wrong area. Ah.
Radiation protection.
I was looking in the wrong area. How many I get from this? 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice. That's 8. Extract those nanites. I think they were talking about an incoming radiation storm. And of course, learn another language. The word for happy. Interesting. And what we'll do is save and chart. We'll continue on our merry little way to the drop pod that we found. Thank you. Okay, let me in. More. 1, 2, 3. Oh, we've already done this one. Huh. No, we haven't. It gypped us. Interesting. This one didn't give us the upgrade. Looks like we're gonna have to find another one, guys. Thank you.
detected.
Really? What are they doing? One load of missiles. It's a nice hauler. Oh, they both have a hauler. Try again. Would you like to try again for a Zenny? Let's see. Ah, there it is. There's my bases. They just won't learn. Have to take this and put it on another I might have to start this on another planet. So I think I'm running dry on drop pod locations here. That might be why we're not getting our upgrades. Almost there. Got 45 seconds. 38. I mean, just look how beautiful this planet is, though. Sure, it's got scars on it. In fact, the scars kind of look like something decided to use a laser on it. Like they're actively trying to, you know, mine the planet for its radiation. I mean, look at that. Atlas Pass thing. More rusted metal. That's 144 rusted metal, guy, or ferrite dust, guys. It's nothing to shake a stick at. Yeah, it's looking like we've run out of upgrades on this planet. You see, it says that I can repair them. But it doesn't let me do anything. So it looks like you do eventually run out. I had no idea. But you may only just run out on the planet. You may not run out just, you know, entirely. And we shall test this by going to another planet. That looks like the planet is going into the planet. The moon's going into the planet. Oops. Running low.
Technology recharge.
I'm gonna have to buy some tritium when I go to the space station next time. This is the hot planet. Might want to make a base here anyway, just because we can mine cobalt. It would only be a very minor planet with basically probably just a room to escape the heat and a landing pad, as well as a pad for our Exocraft. Our roamer. Like how the planet's not too hot for water. That's just kind of cool. Initiating landing sequence. Metal plating and paraffinium. I don't have any paraffinium. That's not good. There's an Exocraft summoning station in the system.
Ground protection falling.
Well, I guess we can't test it because we don't have paraffinium. We'll grab this sodium and get off this rock. We have cobalt to sell. Recharge this. Yeah, it's only 8,517, but we can still crash economies with that. And of course, heading to my capital ship, because it's near the space station. I'd like to eventually put a warp gate on my space station, on my capital ship, as well as a couple of different upgrade modules for teleportation and everything, so I could teleport things to my ship easier. But it's probably not going to be like that. Had to agree with someone's opinion real quick. Wow. Come on, it's gotta be closer than that. Okay, it is. Debrief station. Two Corvax casings. Activate planetary probe. Interesting. Have a large refinery here. Oh, my frigate commander. Interesting. That was kind of cool. Okay, so the one that I have is a trade ship. No upgrade modules. and I have no way to upgrade my base because I don't have any salvage frigate modules because I don't know where to get them. Because this is one of the ones I need is the matter beam. Which I could also use the stellar extractor room? Interesting. And then of course making there's only two things here other than color. I don't think they actually have a gate. Appearance modifier. There it is. Teleport chamber. That's the one I need. Is the teleport chamber. But I don't know how to get those. Yeah, look at this. Paint, and then of course there's also engines. Ooh, emerald. I like. There, now my engines are emerald in color. There's really not much else I can do with this base. Not right now, anyway. I'm gonna have to figure out how to get more of those frigate salvage modules. But anyway, that's gonna be everything for this video, guys. I went over a little bit, but that was because I was more confused on my frigate. So thank you guys so much for stopping by. If you like this video, please be sure to hit that like button, and if you're new to the channel, subscribe. Also comment, even if you're new or not. And as always, I will see you in the next video. And remember, you don't lose, you learn. Gamers, game on.